lives to be transformed. You see, heaven and earth will pass away. With the glory and the beauty of it. But there is one thing that cannot fail. It's your holy written word. And tonight we stand by that word. This is the gathering of the host of heaven. Yes, the precious souls, the angels, the God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, let's rise up to our feet. Let's pray. I know we're here for praise night, but the Lord said to me, pray when you get there, praise the Lord. He said, pray that grace will be added to this church. And there will be numerical strength added to his church. And another prayer point is saying, pray that evil will depart against the church, idle words spoken against his church will not be able to stand. Praise the Lord. So we look at Psalm 91. Psalm 91. Psalm 91, we're going to be reading it together. We find you say, praise the Lord.
And the Lord.
When you hear the church, it doesn't talk about the building, it talks about you and I, it talks about the congregation. Praise the Lord. The people who makes up the place. Psalm 91, let's read from verse 1. It says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I will trust. Now let's begin to thank him. In him we trust. As a church, as a body, he is our hiding place. He's all we count upon. Talk to him. Precious Holy Spirit, your word abides forever and ever. Your word stands sure. Your word says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my strength. Daddy, you say we should pray for numerical strength. Daddy, you are our strength. You are the Lord of harvest. You say pray that laborers will dispatch over this house, that your will be done in the name of Jesus. Father, concerning your plan and purpose for this place, no word, no evil will be able to stand against it. Concerning every life here, every contender, Father, arise and contend with them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father, for honoring our word. In Jesus' name we pray. Verse 3 says, sure, he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover us with his feathers, and under his wings we shall take refuge. His truth shall be our shield and our buckler. Let's turn it into prayer. Precious Holy Spirit, your word is yea and amen. You say, surely you shall deliver your church from the snare of the fowler. Every snare of the fowler that is risen against this church, risen against individuals, risen against the increase, risen against making people weak. Every contender with your church, precious Holy Spirit, arise and contend with them. Even as we lift up the altar of praise and sacrifices tonight, that day that you will lay ambush against the works of hell tonight in this city, every siege against your church, precious Holy Spirit, we dispatch angels to go and contend with them. We overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. In the name of Jesus, thank you, faithful Father, for honoring our word. You say you shall cover your church with your feathers. Under your wings, we hide our children. Under your wings, we hide all that have to do with us. Everything that bear our name, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Holy Spirit. Yeah. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. He say, you shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks by darkness, nor of the destruction that lays with at noonday. Precious Holy Spirit, we shall not be afraid. We are not moved by the devices of evil in the name of Jesus. For your word has gone ahead of us. Your word says we shall not be afraid of them, of those arrows. For it shall not come near us, nor come near our dwelling. With our eyes we will behold the reward of the wicked. In the name of Jesus, precious Father, so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. He said, 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord, who is your refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place. I want you to say, Father, you are my dwelling place. You are our dwelling place. As a family, as a church, we hide ourselves in you. In the name of Jesus, every devices of evil, it shall not come near us. With our eyes we will look and see their reward. So shall it be. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father, for honoring our word. In Jesus' name we pray. Verse 10. It said, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over you, to keep you in all your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. He said, you shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent, you shall trample underfoot. This begin to thank him. We shall trample upon scorpion and serpent under our feet. We have already crushed their head. In this city, they have no ability. All their works have been turned to naught. In the name of Jesus. Precious Father, your word is yea and amen. In Jesus' name we have prayed. For it is because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. I want you to turn it into prayer. He said, because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I want you to say, Father, thank you. Because I have set my love upon you, because your church has set her love upon you, you will deliver your church. Yes, you will set your church on high. Because we have known your name, you will set Victory House on high in this city, in this nation, nations of the world. Individually, you will set us on high. In the name of Jesus. 15 says, we shall call upon him and he will answer us. He said, I will be with him, he will be with us in trouble, and he will deliver us and honor us. With long life, he will satisfy us. He will show us his salvation. I want you to talk to him again. That no one under this canopy, under this ministry, and their family will go to hell. That this place will become a gate to heaven. Precious Father, because we know you. Hey. You will satisfy us with long life. You will honor us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at Isaiah 54. Isaiah 54. Let's read from 13. It says, all your children shall be taught by the Lord, and great shall be the peace of your children. In righteousness you shall be established. You shall be far from oppression, for you shall not fear, and from terror, for it shall not come near you. Let's begin to turn it into prayer. Now lift up your children and say, Father, every child under this canopy, every child under this ministry, and all the children all over the nations of the world, we say, precious Father, according to your word, we say, all our children shall be taught by the Lord, and grace shall be their peace. Father, when they are going on the road, you teach them. Precious Father, when they are on their own, you will teach them wisdom. You will teach them knowledge. You will teach them understanding. You will teach them your ways. You will teach them the fear of the Lord. You will cause them to walk in your ways. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will anoint their head with oil. They will carry grace. They will not deny the gospel of Jesus. They will not walk away from your kingdom. Grace will keep them. Grace will uphold them. Grace will use them. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
15 says, indeed, they shall surely assemble, but not because of me. Whoever assembles against you shall fall for your sake. Father, in the name of Jesus, every gathering contrary to your will concerning my life, concerning your church, Father, every conversation that will bring your word down in my life, in your church, Father, your word says, for my sake they will fall. In the name of Jesus, today that gathering will not hold. In the name of Jesus, thank you, faithful Father, for hearing your word and honoring your word in our heart. In Jesus' name. 16 said, behold, I have created the blacksmith who blows the coals in the fire, who brings forth an instrument of his work, and I have created the spoiler to destroy. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Now we turn it into prayer. Father, every weapon of unrighteousness, every destiny damages, destiny perverters, destroyers, they will not get in contact with me. They will not get in contact with my children, both physical and spiritual children. Father, hey, any road they pass, I will not be there. Every garden where they find themselves, I will not be there. My children will not be there. In the name of Jesus, there shall be no calamity. There shall be no accident. No gunfire. No stray bullets. Father, whether they are going to school, there shall be no evil news. In the name of Jesus. Because you have the power to keep them in perfect peace, to keep us in perfect peace, when we are going and when we are coming, all the days of our life, we will not behold evil, but with our eyes we will see the reward of the wicked. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. It says, and every tongue which rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servant of the Lord, and their righteousness is from me, says the Lord. So now you're going to say, Father, every tongue that risen against me in the year past, every proclamation, every word, be it from my parents, be it from people, wherever it is, every curse, whatever word that is working against me, working against my life, my destiny, my ministry, my business, my children, my family, today, consciously, I erase by the power of the blood of Jesus. That day, I say, let the blood of Jesus begin to flow right now. Let it visit every page of my life, every page of my past, page of my future, that of my children, that of my husband, everything, oh God, that the enemy is using against me. Today, I erase them completely in the name of Jesus. He will not be able to stand against me. I want you to lift up your voice. Yeah, he say, you daughter of Zion, deliver yourself. Even if I'm the one, oh God, that spoke those negativity, today, oh Lord, I erase them in the name of Jesus. For your words say, every tongue, be it my tongue, be it my superiors, be it my words, be it my co-workers, be it my family members, be it the government, whatever authority that works for me or after me or before me, whatever it is that is speaking and is contrary to your word, to your will, today I say, let that voice become silent. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Praise the Lord. Psalm 100. Praise the Lord. Let's read it together. From verse 1. If you are there, say praise the Lord. If you are there, say a living praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Right. If you are there, say praise the Lord that have some elements of life in it. God bless you. If you know that you are there, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah!
Want to let us go? He said, make a joyful shout to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. He said, enter to his gate with thanksgiving and into his court with praise. He said, be thankful to him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So are you going to praise the Lord tonight?
Yes.
Are you going to shout?
Hallelujah.
A joyful shout?
Hey.
Is heaven going to hear your voice? Are you going to worship?
Hallelujah.
Are you just going to make some noise? Praise the Lord. Choir,
hallelujah.
You are blessed.
Hallelujah.
Please, we want to visit the gate of heaven and enter there. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Take us to the throne of grace. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord.